She walked into my office like she was walking onto a beach in France. She was pure sophistication, sex, and grace. And from the moment I saw her, I knew she was going to get me killed. Women that look like that are a walking dead sentence, just waiting for some poor schmuck to be the period, exclamation point, question mark, or semicolon, depending on the use.
Can I ask you a favor?
You can ask, doll.
Dude, it really creeps me out when you call me shit like doll.
What's your name, sweetheart? Call me old-fashioned, but I don't do favors for strangers.
It's me.
Michael.
Michael, huh?
Curious name for a broad. Probably French for Michelle.
Where are you from, gorgeous?
Down the hall.
Ah, I knew it. Knew she had to be from some other far-off place. Somewhere exotic. Where men wore tuxedos to the toilet and women like her still knew their place. Which was anywhere they wanted, but mostly the kitchen. A lady like that, she's not an event. She's a situation. She unfolds over years. Wow, that metaphor got gross in a hurry.
Now they're finally acquainted, Michelle.
Do you mind if I call you Michelle?
So much.
That's good, Michelle. You know, I much prefer the sound of your native tongue to the brutal grunts of English. The tongue I hope to become more, familiar with over time.
Gad! No! Listen!
We've got a problem.
What's with all this wee talk? Haven't agreed to anything yet.
Look, the boss says someone's been stealing office supplies lately. Like, to an insane degree. 18 cases, mind you, of toner went missing just this morning.
He said he's gonna have to fire somebody if it doesn't stop.
So you want to solve the case for you, huh? Is that it, Hot Pants?
Hot Pants? No, I don't want you to solve anything. I want you to stop stealing office supplies.
Fine, I'm on the case. But I get $200 per day plus expenses.
I will absolutely never pay you anything, ever.
And there's just one condition.
No. The answer is no.
When all this is over, you owe me a kiss. I figure a broad like you, you can get your hands on money without much ado. But a kiss, that'll mean something.
How do I...
No, you twist it.
I know you twist doorknobs. It's not budging.
No, you lift.
Lift?
Yeah, lift and separate.
Those legs! Oh!
A little bird told me that a cat by the name of Foster ran supplies in and out of this doghouse. But I was a shark. And if there's one thing sharks are good at, it's getting sheep like Foster to squeal like mice. The tires screamed into the darkness like murder victims. The car barked violently, swerving from lane to lane like a drunk after a three-day bender. I was pretty drunk from this three-day bender, but that was the car, I swear. Sometimes you forget how mad this city is, and then you get on the roads and see it up close and personal, smell the rotten stink of insanity on her breath. The people may seem like polite, well-mannered, well-adjusted folks, but then you hit those streets, and you see how miserable they really are. There's no regard for the sanctity of human life. Mine, yours, their own, on these concrete rivers. Sometimes you'll turn a corner, and they'll just be standing there in the middle of the road, blank, unaware, waiting, hoping, praying for the sweet release of death. Sometimes, that road is a sidewalk. Foster's face went white when he spotted me. I looked into his eyes and smiled. He didn't smile back. Maybe I went a bit too far with Foster, but it was too late now. I was in over my head, swimming deep in a sea of murk and grime and piranhas. Grimy piranhas. I'm gonna cut the animal metaphors now. Foster must have talked, or maybe not, seeing as he was in a coma. Huh, a coma. Isn't that convenient? Whoever was in charge of this fiasco sent one of his goons on me. A human named Munts. Big guy, heavy talker, thick, eyebrows. This internal monologue thing is getting more difficult.
So you're the muscle.
Mr. Brockway. I'm Harold Munts.
I'm with Human Resources. Normally in a situation like this, I explain the complaints that are against you and what company policies they violate. But I think I'm pretty much going to start from the ground up and explain the basic concept of morality and what deadly sins you violate.
You know, we have met before, Mr. Brockway.
Every single day since we hired you.
Man like you? Seems you only come around when someone needs to make a point.
Why do you keep talking like that? Like you're in a detective movie or something. You think you're Sam Spade or... Wait. Good God, is that it? You think you're in a detective movie?
Munt started yapping on about Christ knows what. Sure, I saw his mouth moving, but the words were lost, carried away as if on an ocean breeze. Something Munt had said had got me thinking, and now all the pieces were falling into place.
You're not in a detective movie. You're riding a turtle. A giant one.
Munt seemed to be screaming about something, but I couldn't focus. My head was spinning. Everything was starting to make sense. Somebody was playing me for a sucker here, and I had a pretty good idea who.
You cannot be any further atmospherically from a film noir movie. You're wearing swim trunks and boots. Where do you think you're going?
I've got a theft to solve. And if that life support doesn't hold out, a murder.
But you're the murderer. You hit him with your car, remember?
I knew I'd find you here, Hot Pockets.
Brockway? Of course you'd find me here. This is my house. Why do you have a sword?
Because I figured it all out, sexy ass. The coy nicknames were getting harder and harder to come up with. The poison must be taking effect. Too late. I put it all together, too late. It was easy once I figured out where I knew you were from.
The office. Where we work together every day.
Cairo.
Neither of us have ever been to Cairo. I'm pretty sure you don't know what country it's in.
The museum job. You thought I could forget? Yeah, sure. You fooled me with that fancy accent.
I'm from San Diego.
But then I remember the necklace you wore. And it all came back to me. The Japan heist.
Egypt.
Cairo's in Egypt.
The Emperor's jewels went missing. Along with this. The Sword of Omens!
The what? From Thundercats?
Then things went south for you. So you came to LA to find the one man you knew could not resist your charm. Me! That poison, though? Didn't see that coming. You played me like a sousaphone!
What poison? And why does your breath smell like project reports? Have you
been drinking copy toner?
I did this for you! You got me, baby. You got me good. But not before I did it. Not before I solved the case.
The case? You mean the office supplies. But you stole them. How did you solve the case if you're the one who... Oh, you drank all the office toner. Right. Well, I guess that's solved to you.
Do you remember what you promised me? One consideration. A kiss. A kiss before dying.
But I have man parts!
That's okay, baby. We all have our man parts. I know what yours are. Violence, greed, deception. Me? Mine's a penis.
Mine too!
The last thing a man hears shouldn't be meaningless words. My last sounds are the smack of the soft, protesting lips of the woman that killed me. The ebbing static flow of a distant highway. And for some reason, that song that sounds like, in the big country, dreams stay with you. Man, I hadn't heard that in forever. How did that get in my head?
No. The answer is no. But yes to the hundreds.
Action.
But I have men.
Twist it, you man.
And fall.
your name, sweetheart. Call me old-fashioned, but I don't do strange for favors.
Oh my God!
Sorry.
It hurts when you do it. Do it again. Wake up, so sudden.